Hi, Sutamani here. Just putting a quick video up here on the Scottish independence. That's the vote's coming very soon, within the next year, just over a year now, on 18th of September. I made a blog post about it that you might be interested to have a quick look at. And the question is, should Scotland be an independent country? Now, it's been part of Great Britain for over 300 years, so it's quite a major change that's being proposed. This is Great Britain here, not including Ireland down here, but all the rest is Great Britain. It includes Wales, Northern Ireland, England and Scotland. Scotland there is the red bit. Now, of course, probably the most famous thing, Scotland is well known for all of the inventions, the Enlightenment in the 1700s, a lot of the discoveries that were made, the great thinkers from Scotland, and of course North Sea oil. So if they did separate from the rest of England financially, they would be in charge of the North Sea oil. I'm not sure how much of that's left though. Anyway, there are two sections of Scotland that are marketing and advertising, trying to get you to vote one way or the other. One's called Yes Scotland, in favour of Scottish independence, and Better Together favour Scotland remaining in the United Kingdom. This is the Chief Minister, and there's a bit of a talk there by him, Mr. Salmond, the Scottish First Minister, they call him, First Minister of Scotland. And I've got a list here of the many factors that you need to consider when voting for or against Scottish independence. You might say, what's an Aussie got to do with Scottish independence? Well, I do have Scottish relatives. My sister-in-law is Scottish, and I have some really good friends over in Scotland, so I am interested to see what happens there. I've got a picky there of the Scottish flag, and just a few of the questions there about the sort of things that people will need to discuss in the next 12 months. The population of Scotland's quite small, only 5 million compared to 56 million in England, so it's only one-tenth the population of England. Surprising how powerful Scotland is as a force in the world. Living in Australia, I'm aware of a lot of Scottish people in this neck of the woods. They emigrated here. And of course, when you go to New Zealand, that's when you really realise how many Scots came down there. Pretty much all the towns in New Zealand have Scottish names, Dunedin and so on. So have quite an effect here in the Southern Hemisphere, the Scottish people. Talks about what currency they use, what would be the financial effects of it, and there's a couple of books been written already about it, and I think I'm going to run out of time. So there you are, that's just a brief overview. Have a look at my blog and you'll see a few more links to different places. Cheers for now. Sorry guys, I think it's still taping. I'm trying to find it where it is on here so that I can stop it. It's gone all naughty on me. I'll just turn this off and that'll get